am Anil Kumar. Today we are going to edit this Hawaii chappal or slipper. It's a bathroom slipper and we are going to do high-end editing. What is the difference between high-end editing and just e-commerce editing? In e-commerce editing, we try to edit very fast, but for advertising catalog you need high-end editing. So how we do that? You can see the file info. This image is shot by me using this camera 1DS Mark III, and I have used 2470mm lens. Okay, then now this is a CR2 file, so we can convert it into PSD or TIFF. First thing, to create a clipping path, we are not using magic wand in this, so take pen tool, if you edit jewelry and you have to edit other products, then what you try to do is that make every piece, this is just like a jewelry, you don't take it lightly. You should not try to remove all these things, just make one straight line. This is not the way. This is the feature of Hawaii chappal or slipper, that the person should not slip. So this design helps people to not to slip. So this is one of the feature. You should understand that this image might be used in advertising, for making posters, banners, for shop displays. So it should be very good quality. And if you start looking with that kind of eye, that it should be perfect. So you will try to remove all the faults, no matter how much time it is going to take. After completing the clipping path, this is completed, and now what we can do is we can save this path . The image number is 8152. Okay, now come back to the path. Select the pen tool, again, right click, make selection. Here, if you are making this slipper for advertising or catalog and you are going to paste somewhere, then you need pixel 1 or 0.15 feather. If you are just using for any kind of use, you don't need any kind of feather. So depends where you are going to use. So I'm not putting any kind of feather. I just make clear straight line, no feather. We have to cut inside also, so we'll do that. Press Ctrl J and then go to background layer, white layer, and fill it with white. Now our slipper is in this form. So what we can do now, we can remove this also. Don't try to use magic wand. Then here also, okay, press Ctrl Enter and delete. So this is our transparent slipper. Now we have to finish this slipper. How? Look at this sole. And if you go, this is the texture of the sole. So we can finish this by using healing brush. We can remove all the . We don't have to remove texture, but just the small dust or something. This is die mark. This is not die mark. This is the cutting mark. Press Control Enter, and now you can use this clone tool. Here we see what we are going to do now. Here, take brush tool, opacity 30%, hardness 0%, create a new layer, take sample from here, press Alt. Reduce the opacity a little bit, give the texture. So this is the highlight coming on the slipper. So reduce a little bit more, so the highlight will be there. Okay. Merge this layer, because my style is that I don't keep many layers here. Once job is done, merge the layer, don't keep too many layers. Control D, deselect. Then here is another thing. Make clipping path for here. Make this line outside, not close, so you will know what I'm going to do now. Yes, control enter. Create a new layer. Go to edit, stroke, and stroke color. Take sample from here. Then pixel, try with 10. This is the dark color, so we'll change the color. You can take sample from here. Okay. Now you see this line is Control D on separate layer. You can adjust this line. Then cut this line first. Now we have this line. This is the guiding line. We can put it here. We can adjust the shape also. Press Control T. Warp. Then go to layer 1, create new layer, take stump tool, all layers, and now press Alt here, press size, not big. After this finishing, you can finish here also. Not much, because this is a texture. We are not going to remove texture. This one. Then merge all these three layers. Come to the straps. Create a new layer. Select inverse. Ctrl D, deselect, and now select inside. This is looking very ugly. Lot of marks. Create a new layer, and now take brush tool, opacity 30, hardness 100%, take sample nearby area. The highlights, press Ctrl Enter first, then end. Okay, then we can't reduce opacity because it's too dirty there. If we reduce opacity, this will look like this. Better not to reduce. Here is also same problem. It's very dirty. Press Ctrl Enter, create a new layer. You should create new layers all the time for each activity. Don't try to work on one layer. When you work with less opacity, then you have control where you have to give highlight or where you have to paint harder. Depends, because highlight is the main thing you have to maintain. Then go to select inverse and here . So what we see now, we are here. We can merge these layers together. Save your file, PSD file. Then come to this portion. Create a clipping path for this portion. Create a new layer. We cannot use stamp tool because this is going to replace there. I just want that some smooth shining here. I'll increase the opacity to make it 30%. And then this is the dimmer. This is the dimmer I have to hide. And highlight should be there. Make it smooth. What you see here, two colors, cyan and blue. You can make it this color also blue. Or this can make your cyan also, but this cells in blue. Here you can make it a little bit darker, but I'm just leaving it as like that because this is the natural color. So we should not change the product, we should finish only. But if client demands, you can finish this. After this, come here. We see here these marks. Here, make path on all these points. That now press right button mouse, make selection, put one feather, create new layer, can we copy somewhere? If we can copy, that would be better. So we have one choice is that we can paint. Make highlight also. Control D. This is the one way. Another way is that you can copy this portion and like this. Go to layer 6, Control C or V, then you can replace this with everywhere on all the dirty marks. This is not there. This is dirty. So you take from a good place and you can paste here. So anyway, we are here. After this, look here. What is there? Created earlier and now we see here shadow, so we cannot cover the shadow. Select inside inverse and here. Control T, then only this portion. create a new layer and Control D. Merge all these layers. Then make a copy of this and feather blur surface blur. So we see here blur and it looks neat. So what we are going to do now, create a clipping path here. Then apply hide all mask, press control enter and now change the color to white and paint. So we are revealing this blur only on the this surface blur only on the sole, not everywhere. One place, control D, then we come to this portion. Here it is not smooth, it is dirty here, so we can finish this first and we can apply here first, we can try that. You can merge this mask and a little bit finishing required here. and most important is the logo. So we have to make this logo very neat, because logo is the main thing you should be careful about. Merge this layer first and contours are important. So if you don't get any kind of highlight here, you can create the highlight like this. Take some from here. It might take some time in finishing each part. Then make a copy of this. Go to filter, sharpen, sharp mask. Don't apply too much sharpness. To this shadow part. Merge both the layers first. For shadow, go to all six zeros, black total, hardness 0, opacity 100%. You can first change the angle, whatever you want. Then go to layer 2, create new layer. Take eraser tool, 0 hardness. 100%. So if you put it here, this is like touching the background, touching the board. But if you put this shadow below, this will start floating. Crop the mesh according to your size. Make this a little bit lighter because the distance from here to here is less and here is harder. Okay, thank you so much.